We begin with breaking news, and a third teenager has just been arrested over the suspected murder of a 56-year-old man whose body was tied up and dumped on the state's south coast. Two other 17-year-olds have been arrested and charged with murder this afternoon after father of three, Peter Keeley, was found dead in bushland at Browley nearly 2 weeks ago.
Police will allege that the method of communication between the victim and one of the teenagers was the dating app, and one of those dating apps was Grindr.
Detectives are investigating whether it could have been a hate crime. We'll have the latest from our reporter Emma Partridge at 4:30. New South Wales is bracing for strong winds and powerful surf conditions as ex-tropical cyclone Yusei tracks closer to the Australian coast. The Bureau of Meteorology has issued a hazardous surf warning for Byron Bay today and for most of our coastline tomorrow.
Very dangerous surf conditions. We're expecting mean wave height of 7 metres and peak height could be double that.
It comes as the state prepares for another drenching following last week's storm. 21,000 homes and businesses are still without power. Ausgrid insists staff are working around the clock to ensure the situation is fixed as soon as possible.
We're working very hard and we've got additional resources. So in the field and in the restoration efforts, we've now got over 1,100 people working to restore power safely for the weekend.
Ausgrid says the destructive storm was the second largest in its history. Well, next to Canberra and federal politics reporter Fiona Willen, good afternoon to you, Fee. Rebel Nationals MPs have been told to pull their heads in.
Amber, the party's big boss has stepped in and he's had a few words to say to some of his MPs. Larry Anthony is the federal president of the Nationals and he says members need to get on with the job and that it doesn't help them or the party to be destabilising the leader, Michael McCormick. Now, this comes after 2 weeks of rather obvious disunity within the Nationals. Of course, it started with Barnaby Joyce's failed leadership challenge last week and then it continued this week when MP Lou O'Brien quit the party room over concerns about Mr McCormick's leadership. And something that's unlikely to help smooth things over, this afternoon Mr Joyce has released a podcast with Nationals colleague Matt Canavan talking about the spill. And then just a short time ago, Mr Joyce has spoken with Ben Fordham on 2GB Radio. Take a listen.
Every time I open the TV now, I hear that I'm trying to bring down the government, and I'm certainly not trying to do that.
It's Michael McCormick, mate.
But Michael McCormick is the McCormick Morrison government has got to prevail and got to win. Colleagues and myself had a shot. We lost, and when you lose, and that's it. And now you move on. And
you're not going to BS people though, and pretend that you're friends, right?
I'm going to say that, you know, respect the job he does.
Now, this afternoon, Cabinet's National Security Committee is meeting to discuss the coronavirus. It is expected that they'll announce a travel ban for visitors from China will be extended. Amber?
OK, Fiona, thank you. Two gunmen are on the run in Sydney after shooting a 30-year-old man in the stomach. This report from Tiffany Genders.
Police are treating this as an attempted murder, blocking off the streets surrounding this two-storey brick home in Lansvale. It was just after three this morning when two men paid a visit to the granny flat at the back of this property, opening fire on a 30-year-old. He was taken to Liverpool Hospital with a bullet still lodged in his chest. He's in a critical condition, undergoing surgery. There was a young woman who witnessed the ambush. She is said to be distraught, but assisting detectives.
We believe that the incident is a targeted attack. However, we're keeping an open mind considering it's early in the investigation.
Police are now hunting two male suspects. They were last seen running away down Huntingdale Avenue.
Dairy Farmers has issued an urgent recall for its 1 and 3 litre milk varieties, which have been sold across the state. The company today pulling the products off supermarket shelves over potential E. coli contamination. The recall applies to 3 litre bottles with an expiry date of February 24 and 1 litre bottles with an expiry date of February 25. Police are searching for three men wanted over a stabbing in our state's central west. Amy Clements has more.
The trio's crime spree has spanned hundreds of kilometres, taking a violent turn at a home on the outskirts of Orange. The three men forcing their way into the shed of a Clifton Grove property early yesterday morning, threatening the owner and stabbing him. The 37-year-old's attackers stealing his Holden Commodore and fleeing the scene.
The 37-year-old male sustained some injuries to his back, torso and hand during the course of that assault. He was treated at Orange Hospital and we understand he's in a stable condition.
A burnt-out Hyundai was also found by police yesterday. It's believed the trio had stolen it last Saturday in Bathurst and rammed it through a roller door at a petrol station in Orange. The bandits remain at large and were last spotted in parks. Police now asking for any witnesses to come forward.
Telco giants Vodafone and TPG have been given the all clear for a $15 billion merger, with the federal court throwing out a ruling from the consumer watchdog that it would be anti-competitive. It comes as Telstra this morning released its half-year profits, down 7.6% compared to last year, with a net profit of $1.14 billion.